Today's show is pre-recorded.
Y'all know what time it is.
Y'all don't know, y'all better ask somebody.
Hat on, hat on, suit on, suit on, looking like the Capitol, giving a microphone, dress, dress like a million bucks, buttons, things in its cuffs. Y'all tell me, who could it be but Steve Harvey?
Oh, yeah.
Everybody out there listening to me. Put your hands together.
Oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh,
listen. Why don't you join me?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, 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 oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh,
me.
Oh, 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 oh,
I sure will. Good morning, everybody. You are listening to The Voice. Come on, dig me now. One and only, Steve Harvey. Oh, yeah, man. Got a radio show. Do you understand that? I'm telling you, God been big in my life. I'm not going to kid you. I'm telling you, and he'll do the same thing for you. God is a gentleman. You know, I want to point that out to you. God is an absolute gentleman. He will not come in unless he's invited. He don't just barge into your life. He gives us the power of choice. You know, if you say you got it, I don't need you, he lets you have it. If you say, I need you, come see about me, he right there. It's just a real simple thing, man. So I always say to people this, if you've gotten yourself into something, and please know I have. I was stuck. I thought a couple of times, well, might not make it past this one. But then if I don't make it past it, what's going to happen? And then I held on to this little thing that my mother kept talking to me about. She said, sometimes, son, when you ain't got nothing else in you, just hope. She said, just hope it'll be all right. You know, and what I've learned in my life is that hope is the beginning of faith. Hope is just, is there a possibility out there for me? I sure hope something happened. See, hope is okay, man. Because like I say, for me, the way I've lived my life, hope was the beginning of faith. It was just the idea. It's just the thought that something could change for me. That something could be a little bit different from it. That maybe, man, just maybe, for some reason, I could be saved. I could be rescued. Things could turn around. It could head in the other direction. Maybe I could quit messing up. Maybe somebody will forgive me. Maybe somebody will just say, all right, I don't know. But I can't count the times I've been in that position. But then, once I hope a little bit, and then I remember also my mother, because she was a Sunday school teacher. She taught me the most valuable lesson I've ever learned in my life. Nothing has been greater in my life than my faith. She taught me to pray. Mama used to say, when it get real dark for you, son, prayer changes things. She said, when you seem like you lost and you can't find your way, stop and pray. She said, because prayer changes things. You know, when you get a point in your life when you've done all you can do and you can't do no more and you just don't know what to do next. She says, stop, son. Pray. And combine that prayer with that hope that you got. She said, because that hope is the beginning of faith. She said, if you pray just hoping, she said, if God come through for you, that'll give you confidence that he can do it again. And then after a while, you quit hoping. She said, you start believing. She said, and that's when you're on to something. If you can turn that hope into belief, that hope into faith, the ability to believe in something that you can't see. But the key, though, to faith is you're believing in something that you can't see. See, hoping a little bit different for me. Now, I'm pretty sure, like I say oftentimes, I tell a lot of people who can explain this thing a lot better than I can to you. But just from my side of it, being as real as I can be with you. See, hope helps, man. If you ain't strong enough to have faith, have hope. And then if you pray with some hope and God answers your prayer, then that hope gains a little confidence. And after a while, that confidence becomes faith. Now it ain't just hoping, but I'm believing. I'm believing in something that I cannot see. Faith has been the key to my entire existence, even when I didn't have any. It was faith, as I look back on it, that has gotten me here. And not just faith, but my faith. See, you will only get to where you're going in your life based on your faith. See, a lot of people get the word faith confused. Like, what's your faith? And then they start going down this whole list of all these different religions out here. But really, in essence, man, when I talk to people about faith, I'm talking to you about your belief. How much do you believe in the unseen? How much do you believe in the things you can't see? How much do you believe in the impossible? How much do you believe? See, because faith is the belief in things that you cannot see. Faith is the core of all that is happening to me today. It is the faith that I have in my relationship with God that enables me to just oftentimes, if I stay on the right course and believe a certain way and act a certain way, his blessings just pour. They just come. And it comes in a lot of little ways too, I've started to notice. See, it ain't just, a lot of people think blessings is money. No, man, that ain't it. It's coverage. It's every time my plane lands safe. It's every time they predict bad weather and I get up in the sky and it don't be no bad weather. You know, this is favor. These are blessings that get poured out to me. Somebody call me and offer me something. Not money, but an opportunity. You know, somebody say, hey, man, I don't know, but I sent this to you. I thought you might be interested in it. Somebody will send me a scripture or somebody will send me something. That's favor. And it always comes at a time when I need it the most. That's favor. That's pouring out blessings. Now, I'm also the recipient of a lot of other blessings, too. You know, I've been blessed with health. That's amazing blessing, man. I've been blessed with a spirit of not quitting. I've been blessed with the ability to shoulder huge amounts of responsibility. See, blessings come a lot of ways. But once you tie in to God, once you tie in and you start doing the best you can do, and you start asking for him to make you a better person, to help shape and mold you into the kind of man or person that he wants you to be, you'd be amazed what God can do with you, man, if you just invite him in and allow him to be a part of your life. I mean, what you got to lose out there? Come on. If you're sitting in the cell this morning, why would you not change? You have a chance to turn your life around with a relationship with God. What you waiting on? Are you going to just keep doing it like that, huh? Really? Come on, man. Why would you do that to yourself? Why would you not allow God to be a part of your life? So you can get to where he wants you to be. God got some big plans for you. If he didn't, you wouldn't keep waking up.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, animal trainers, monkey lovers, people that's crazy about chimpanzees, and anybody in PETA, and all those people who care for fur. This is the Steve Harvey Morning Show. We are deliberate today. Extremely deliberate, which means in common terms, we bout it. Sheryl Strawberry.
Bout it, baby. Good morning, Steve.
Carla Pharrell.
Sing it, baby. Good morning. What's up, crew?
Oh, that doggone junior boy.
Man, morning, Unc. Morning, everybody. I will wear alligator's ass hat. I will.
Dog, put him right on in the form of a belt, a bag, shoes, or a vest. Don't make me no difference.
I'll
put it on. I got alligator hats.
Have you guys ever eaten alligator?
Hell yeah.
Eat alligator.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, Louisiana, New Orleans.
Shirley, stop making faces. You never even tried it.
I would never try it.
Shirley, why? You ain't never tried rabbit. It's delicious.
I would never try rabbit because it's a rabbit and because it's an alligator. I can't. Just my mind won't take me there. I can't do it. Mm-mm.
You don't like see them walking across the table and then while you eating them.
I just can't do it. Well, let me ask you a question.
How do you fix in your mind that this chicken? How do you fix in your mind that? Because it's a chicken, you know.
Right. I grew up with, you know, knowing about chicken, eating chicken. So, I mean, that's something I'm used to.
A cow, you know, like when you're driving down the street and like down the road in the country, you see a cow. Don't never bother you that could be the one.
I'm fascinated by cows. I'm always saying, oh, here's a cow. Yeah, it doesn't bother me. I hardly ever eat red meat, so.
Wow.
It doesn't bother me. Mm-mm, but an alligator, when you get exotic like that, it bothers me.
Yeah, I've had ostrich, everything.
Mm-hmm.
Wild boar.
Rich.
Oh, man,
wild boar. I've had wild
turtle.
Boar.
Turtle soup.
You ate a turtle soup.
God. Turtle soup's delicious.
Frog legs and all that stuff.
Hell yeah, frog legs.
See, I can't
damn near teared up eating them.
It wasn't nothing but a drumstick. Huh?
Yeah, that's all they
eat.
Ain't
nothing but a drumstick. Like chicken. Yeah.
Venison.
Yeah.
Deer.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Deer.
Elk.
No.
Yeah. Oh no.
Oh yeah. Buffalo.
No.
Bison.
Oh, buffalo burger is the best. That's bison. It's the best. Surely you're missing
some
great things in life. You can't what?
I can't eat it. I can't. I told you.
Stop.
I can't do it. Sorry.
I'm sorry.
I don't play when it comes to food like that. I just don't.
If an alligator could eat you, he ain't gonna say, I surely I can't.
No.
I'd be happy
to wear them, a pair of shoes, a nice bag.
It's in my mind.
But eating them, nope. No, thank you.
Kudu, you never had kudu? Goat?
Goat? No.
Goat?
Yeah.
Lamb?
Yeah.
Try lamb.
Yeah, I've had lamb. I do like lamb chops. Yeah.
Snake, like rattlesnake.
No!
Well, you know I'm not going to eat that.
All right, look, we got to go. Coming up in 32 minutes after the hour, ask the CLO, the CLO, Chief Love Officer Steve Harvey in the building right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Time now for Ask the CLO. All you have to do is go to Steve Harvey FM to submit your questions for the Chief Love Officer. Are you ready, sir?
Bone ready.
All right. Calvin in Seattle says, I'm a 47-year-old married man and I have a blended family with my wife. She's Caucasian and I'm African-American. My children are both in college, but her two teenagers live with us. We've never had the same parenting style, so I just bite my tongue and overlook a lot. Because
did he
I
say
know
both her children live with them?
My children are both in college, but her two teenagers live with them.
Okay.
We've never had the same parenting style, so I just bite my tongue and overlook a lot because I know the children will be out of the house soon. But over the past 3 weeks, her 16-year-old daughter's boyfriend has been spending the night at our house. If they fall asleep watching the movies, they sleep together on our sofa. I don't like it one bit, but my wife says it's innocent and she did it when she was a teenager. Should I let it go or put my foot down?
No, walk in there and wake his ass up and say, hey, little man, it's time for you to move on. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't care what the wife say. It might be innocent. Get your innocent ass up and go home.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you said they have two different parenting styles. Yeah,
this ain't about parenting. This boy ain't changed your child.
Mm-hmm.
Wake up, my man. Wake up. You got to go home. Mm-hmm. Sorry about that. You can't spend the night in my house. You're not married. I don't care about this. Bye. Where your parents at?
Mm-hmm. You know the daughter's going to run to the mom.
He not staying over here spending the night at my house.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm not sleeping with this boy in my house. I don't know him. Wake up somebody else standing on my bed with a butcher knife.
Okay. All right, so the dad, the man of the house, should go wake him up.
I don't all care right. who. You're not falling asleep over here, partner. Mm-hmm. Let's go. Let's move on.
Because mm-hmm. it's okay with the mom, so the mom and the
I was in college and used to fall asleep over my girlfriend's house.
Mm-hmm.
Dog, I had to go home.
Yeah, yeah.
And we was dating heavy in college, but we was both in Cleveland. Mm-hmm. I couldn't spend the night at her house. You got to go, my man.
Okay.
Whatever y'all doing in college, that's on y'all. But when you come here, you got to respect my house.
Under my roof.
Go to sleep.
Yeah.
That's all.
Yeah. All right. Moving on, CLO. Sue in Columbus, Georgia says, I've been married for almost 40 years, and I think my husband is cheating. We're both retired, but he's been helping out his friend that owns a hardware store. Since then, I've noticed a big change in him. He is very conscious about what he wears out of the house now, and he douses his clothes in this new cologne he got. I usually give him cologne for Christmas, and he's been wearing the same one for years. He told me his buddy at the job gave it to him. I didn't press the issue, but I am worried that there's another woman in the picture. Do you think he's cheating?
Well, first of all, let's start with this cologne you get him at Christmas. He don't want it no more.
Uh-uh.
You want to try somebody. Y'all been married 40 years. People get sick of Brute.
Mm. Not the Brute,
you know,
though.
Everybody don't want Brute by Fabergé. Everybody don't want no Avon Wild Country. Everybody don't want that. Everybody don't want no old ass gray flannel. We tired of smelling like gray flannel. Everybody don't like Fahrenheit.
Yeah. Oh wow, throwback.
Yeah, you still buying your man Polo. He don't want Polo no more.
Polo no more.
No more.
It was
and
easy to
conscious of how he dressing. Who got to dress up at the hardware store?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Always notice that change in behavior.
Get this red apron on and come on down here.
Right.
Ain't sister place where the hardware man is.
With the helpful hardware man.
Yeah. Well, the Ace Hardware man is real helpful.
So he's cheating? You think he's cheating?
No, I ain't say that.
That's what she wants to know.
I didn't say that at all.
He don't want that cologne. That's what she wants to know.
But where is he dressing up at the hardware store?
Uh-huh.
Well, and who he wearing this cologne for? What dude gave him some? What dude give a dude some damn cologne? Man, let me tell you something, man. I done had partners my whole life. I ain't never gave a dude a bottle of cologne. I don't give a damn how you smell.
We just friends.
Because if you stink around me, joke's on you, partner. You're going to get a nickname, Funky Dunk, on you.
You're not saying it, Steve, but it sounds like he's cheating. You're not saying that.
I'm not saying it because I don't know that.
Mm,
but
right.
Ain't no man bought another man no cologne. Mm-hmm. Who you know dress up down at the hardware store?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right. Sounds like it to me.
She didn't ask you, Shirley.
He's getting ready to. How about that?
She didn't ask you, Shirley.
Yeah,
keep moving because... He didn't ask you. She didn't ask you, Sheryl. Next question. Let's keep moving. CLO questions
cheating.
Only. Claude questions. Let's go.
You just don't want to do it because he's a man. Constance
no,
in
no,
Tampa.
No, no, no. It ain't that. It's just there's no proof. But you got evidence. Trust your intuition,
mm-hmm.
lady.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
You always say
that's
that.
Right.
No, that's
right. My husband and I have been married for 6 months. This is from Constance in Tampa. And I found out he had a newborn baby 2 weeks before our wedding. My husband's mother told me, and I was so hurt, but I didn't cancel the wedding. My husband has done all he can to regain my trust, but he won't control his mother. His mom always throws the baby up in my face and sends pictures of the baby, saying how much the baby looks like my husband. In due time, I'll warm up to the child, but his mama needs to chill. He says he's not getting into it with his mama. Was marrying him a mistake?
Was marrying him a mistake? Well, let's look at this. You found out 2 weeks before the wedding that he had a baby. Right? Now, he'd been married 6 months, right? She found out 2 weeks before the wedding he had a baby.
Okay. Newborn.
And the baby kind of bought it up, newborn. And now the mama keeps sending pictures of them. Buddy boy looks just like you. And you want to know. Buddy boy looks just like you. Don't he? Won't he? He don't look like Will, but you.
Wilbur. Right.
So, I mean, was it a mistake? If you have regrets, yeah.
All right. Thank you, CLO, as always. Coming up next, he's not here, but the junior is in for the nephew with Run That Prank right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Coming up at the top of the hour, Miss Ann will have today's national news, plus an entertainment news still trending. Tyler Perry is a billionaire with a B. And in other entertainment news, people are really upset that Nancy Pelosi went to a hair salon. We'll talk about all of these stories at the top of the hour. But right now, Junior is in for the nephew with Run That Prank Back. What you got for us, Junior?
David Mann. That's it. David Mann, a.k.a. Mr. Brown.
Okay.
David Mann. Come on.
Hello.
Hey, Miss Sandra.
Yes.
How you doing? This is Nephew Tommy.
I'm doing fine.
Yes, ma'am. We're going to prank phone call your son, David Mann, today, all right?
Okay.
So here's what I want you to do for me. I want you to call David and tell him, hey, them people came over here asking me about paying that bill. And I'm not paying that bill. And that man got smart with me, and I shut the door on him. I told him to call you.
Okay.
When you get through with him, I'm going to call him back as if I'm that man.
Okay. Okay. I'm fitting to do an add-on then.
That's what you call it, an add-on? Okay. Do the add-on then.
Hold on.
All right. Okay. We'll figure it out. I'll call you when we get through.
All right.
Okay, then. Bye-bye.
Hello?
You did good, though.
Okay.
All right. He'll call you back in a minute complaining that we done pranked him, all right?
Okay.
All right. God bless you.
Bless you, too.
Bye-bye. All right. Let's go.
Hello?
Ever bring me that paperwork on apartment 314? Hello? I'm looking for David, please.
This is David.
Okay. This is Jim out at Barton Green Apartments. Is your mother Miss O'd?
Yes, sir. How can I help you?
Okay, we got a problem here. Now, I'm the new general manager here, and I'm just getting this thing brought to me about your mother not paying her water bill, and we got to get this matter taken in. As of right now, I've been instructed to actually go in and get your mother and take her completely out of the apartment building.
Okay, so tell me what the problem is. Explain to me what the situation is, sir.
The situation right now is no one has paid this water bill whatsoever. She thinks, from my understanding, that she only owes $106, and she owes far more than that. She has not paid a water bill at all. Right? Your mother, and I'll be the first one to tell you, your mother was very rude to me and slammed the door in my face.
Okay, sir, I'm just trying to understand the situation. So the water bill hasn't been paid in how long?
From what I'm looking at, it's at least 4 or 5 months from what it looks like here on the paper.
Okay. So it's 4 or 5 months behind.
Yes, it is.
Okay. And so how much is it?
I'm going to have to tally all this up and get everything lined up as far as the numbers. As of right now, sir, if no one is paying this bill in the next 30 minutes, I am instructed to put your mother out and pack her things and put her out. And that's not what I want to do. But as rude as she was to me, you know, at this point, I'll tell you what, David, I don't give a damn.
Sir, so I'm just here to try to help make the situation better. So I need you to take a deep breath for me and calm down, because I'm calm. So let's just let every, you know, I understand what's going on. I would be
calm too had your mother not have slammed the door in the face and said some things before she shut that door. I'd be trying to work as calmly as you're working.
That's right. So what do we need to do? I won't be able to do it within 30 minutes, but how much is it? Just find out how much it is. You know, from what my understanding was, it was $109 or something, $106 for at least 4 months. Is that what the problem is?
No. What is owed right now, the $106, sir, is 1 month.
How is it? I guess my question is, How does the water bill $106 for a one-bedroom apartment with one person? $106 water bill is kind of high, don't you think?
I mean, I don't have no idea what your mother's doing. Well, I don't know if she runs a lot of water, or I have no idea about that part.
Unless she's washing every day and running all the water every day, $106 for an apartment is a bit extreme. I mean, wouldn't you say so yourself? That's a bit high, sir.
I understand that you have some issues about what the amount of the bill is. That does not get in the middle of the fact of how far behind we are.
Okay,
that's the problem we have.
How far behind are we? I'm trying to resolve the issue.
We are 5 months behind.
5 months behind. So how much is the bill for 5 months?
I'm getting her to tally that up as of right now. But let's get back to the issue of someone not being able to get here in 30 minutes. Is there no one that can get here and take care of this bill in 30 minutes?
Let's figure out how much it is, and I'll try to get that worked out. So if you can give me kind of a tally on what it is.
If I had to guesstimate, I mean, let's look at the fact that here it is $106 on 1 month. You know, let's say it's roughly $100 each month. You know, you're looking at $500 at least.
Yes, sir. I have to say $100 for that's extreme.
You know the problem that bothers me, that you people won't pay your bill.
Sir, wait a minute now. I need you to relax, because I pay my bill.
You got a mother over here that apparently you must be the caretaker of, and you're not taking care of your mother from what it seems like.
Okay, what I need you to do is relax and not be accusatory. That's what I need you to do. I need you to...
What I need you to do is stand up, sir, and take initiative of whatever your responsibility is. And if you're responsible for your mother, then you should take care of your mother.
You know what? You're upset right now, and you're not going to get me upset with you, because you don't know what's going on. And so
do you not care about your mother? Because in that case, I can just get off the phone with you. Right now, my job is to get her out of the apartment and pack her things up, because the bill's not paid, and she's saying she's not paying it, to take it up with her son.
What you're trying to do is get me to be where you are. I'm not going to with you.
I'm not trying to get you to be where I am. I'm trying to get you to take care of your mother, if that's your responsibility. Now, if it's not, I'll leave it up to her.
You and I going back and forth on the phone, and you having the attitude that you have, what good is that going to do? What is it going
to
solve?
Are you somebody that sits at home and you need to get your up and get a job? What do you need to do to get your mom taken care of so I can get this paid, and this is not on my desk?
I'm not going to be another angry black man with you, sir. I have a lot more sense than that. So
you're not an angry black man. You're a lazy black man. That's the problem with you people.
What is you people?
Those that don't want to work, want to sit around, want to get a welfare check every day, when the rest of us out here hustling and busting out.
When the who's out busting what? I don't understand.
Are you illiterate or just dumb?
You're the manager of the apartment?
You want to know who I am?
Yes.
I am Nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show. And your mother and your son, David Mann Jr., got me to prank your behind.
Oh, y'all see?
David.
I just saw him record him, because I'm about to get him fired.
What's up, David? You are the first celebrity that has kept his composure, man.
Tell me, I hate you, man. You got me.
You got to do this for me. David Mann, Mr. Brown, what is the baddest radio show in the land?
The Steve Harvey Morning Show. I got pranked by Nephew Tommy.
Huh? See, David Mann.
Come on, but praise
that's
yourself.
That's what that was.
Baby, praise yourself.
Because I'm telling you, because when you come up with just a regular name, that lets you know I'm a king right there.
Boy,
that's
one
how
of
I
the
do
best.
It. See, I
praise
ain't even
yourself.
Change the title. I just said David Mann.
All right, thank you, guys. Coming up at the top of the hour, we'll have some entertainment and national news for you right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
In entertainment news, as we told you yesterday, Tyler Perry joined the 3 Comma Club, a remarkable feat considering he was once living in his car, Steve Harvey. Sound
familiar?
That's what
I keep banking mine on.
Yes. So Tyler's officially a billionaire with the B, according to the accountants at Forbes magazine. They calculate his income in the last 15 years to be $1.4 billion. Tyler earned so much because Check this out. Okay, he demands to own 100% of everything he writes and produces. And he writes and produces everything. This includes 1,200 TV episodes, 22 movies, and 24 stage plays, okay? He opened a $250 million, 330-acre Tyler Perry Studios in Atlanta, where his TV shows are taped. So, I mean, you know, he keeps the money
there right now.
Close to home. What, say it again, Steve?
I'm taping that right now. Man, let me tell y'all something. Tyler Perry is one of the smartest guys I know because I know where it come from.
Yeah,
I don't know all the details, just like nobody knows all the details about anybody.
Right.
But when I tell you somebody who really, really put the work in, Tyler Perry put the work in. You don't get to be a billionaire without some serious effort. I can promise you that because I'm not one, and I know how hard it is for me to just maintain this. This boy right here is one of the coolest dudes, man.
Oh, yeah.
If it's for information, he'll take the time to give you information. Now, don't go over there asking for no money. I ain't never done that. But if you want some information. And the most advice Tyler has ever given me has been mostly spiritual advice, mostly. You know,
nice.
You know, when we talk, you know, we talk mostly about, you know, faith and God and working hard and dreams and visions, and he's just an extremely inspirational dude, you know. And I mean, he has survived all the tabloid mess, which once again has taught me a lot about how to handle it, because he just keeps it moving, man.
He keeps it moving. Hey, Steve, let me ask you something about you and Tyler's relationship. Have you guys ever talked about collabing, doing something together?
I got one thing I'm going to take to him. First time ever. You'll find out. But you know, it's like this, man. I've never really, other than the kings of comedy, I never really got with people to collab. You know, it's not that I don't want to. It's just, I'm going to tell you the truth about this business, man. It doesn't do a lot for unity. This business is so few parts available for African-American men. That very rarely can they band together to do things unless they create. The person who tried it and was the most successful for a brief time was Eddie Murphy. And he did it because they created the Rat Pack. It was him, Arsenio, Robert Townsend, and the Wayans brothers, and a couple other people. And it didn't last. But when he did Harlem Nights, it was his way of reaching to the greats, Red Fox, Richard Pryor, you know.
Robin
Hood.
And he got beat up for doing that. But the dude, Eddie Murphy made a real, real mark. But this boy, Tyler, the truth, the real truth.
Man. Oh, yeah.
Great guy, too. Great guy.
Yeah, he is mad
so successful.
Cool.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you. We look forward to that collabo, Steve. Let's go to the headlines now, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Ann Tripp.
Thank you very much, everybody. Yes, and after that, there was the Black Pack, which included my friend Isaac Hayes and Denzel Washington and some others as well. This is Ann Tripp with the news. Democratic presidential candidate Joe Biden heads to Kenosha, Wisconsin today, one day after President Trump went there. Biden's reportedly scheduled to meet with the family of Jacob Blake, the now paralyzed young Black man. He's expected to address the reason for the continued nights of protest, police brutality, and also, though, to condemn the violence, which he has done all along. Donald Trump talked about the protest yesterday, but instead of meeting with the Blake family, he met with a local gathering of law enforcement to support them and talk about his concept of law and order, something that Biden says reveals more about the current occupant of the White House than people think.
He may believe mouthing the words law and order makes him strong, but his failure to call on his own supporters to stop acting as an armed militia in this country shows how weak he is.
President Trump, meanwhile, was in North Carolina yesterday, where he declared the port city of Wilmington a World War II heritage city. By the way, Wilmington, just so you know, folks out there, less like Tulsa, Oklahoma, was the scene of the massacre of scores of working and middle-class blacks back in 1898 because they were voting and they had a lot of positions of power and they worked hand-in-hand with the white population of that city. So white supremacists didn't like that. Wilmington went from a prosperous mixed-race city to a majority white one overnight. The McDonald's organization is being accused of racial discrimination against black franchisees, allegedly denying them the same opportunities that their white counterparts get and therefore setting them up, they say, for failure. The complaint filed by 52 former franchisees accuses McDonald's of steering black owners to less profitable locations, often in the poorest crime-ridden areas. And because of that, the number of black-owned McDonald's has dropped by 50% over the last 20 years. McDonald denies the accusations. And get this. The late Breonna's ex-boyfriend, Breonna Taylor's ex-boyfriend, says that the district attorney in Louisville is willing to pay real dirty to keep three white cops from facing charges in her murder. The ex, Jamarcus Glover, is reportedly implicated in a drug case. And NPR says that his attorney says prosecutors offered him a plea deal if he would lie and claim that Breonna Taylor, an emergency medical technician, was actually selling drugs with him. And he said no. That's where attorney Scott Barton says the client refused to falsely implicate the dead young woman. The Rock says he has COVID-19. His children, his wife, they all have tested positive, but their whole family's on the mend and they're no longer contagious. And sad news. Yeah, we're talking legendary Mets pitcher Tom Seaver, who has died at age 75. They say he died of dementia and COVID-19. Now back to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Today, Democratic presidential nominee Joe Biden will travel to Kenosha, Wisconsin. He's going to meet with the family of Jacob Blake, the black man who was shot in the back 7 times by a white police officer in front of his 3 children. Citizens, of course, were outraged, and this caused protests in Kenosha. Joe Biden will also hold a community meeting in Kenosha to try to heal and address the social injustice challenges we face. Biden's visit comes after Democratic Governor Tony Evers asked President Trump not to visit. But we all know he did it anyway.
But he did it, and he went up there to drum up more support for his base. Because what he talked about, man, even when he talked about the 17-year-old that killed those 2 people, he said, you know, he was trying to be of assistance. And, I mean, he could have been afraid for his life. I mean, there's a lot here we don't know. No, man, you took a gun and you went and you killed 2 people.
Yeah, we saw the video.
And
ABC now, News posted the video. We saw
one.
It.
Seriously injured another
and
one.
And this right-wing organization I heard today is paying for his defense fund.
Yes, I read that too,
yeah,
Steve.
Yeah, he is a very conservative attorney and all of that. Yeah.
It doesn't matter, man. You killed somebody.
Mm-hmm. 2 people.
Because you took a gun 17. Somewhere. To me, that's premeditated. That's murder one. And stop all this manslaughter. You took a gun down there. You didn't have to take a gun for what?
Yeah.
No, man, this is wrong. He mentioned that, and that's what he said about that. And he never mentioned Jacob Blake.
Not by
Trump.
Name.
Said his name.
And his idea of calming it was, you know, there's police that they choke. It happens.
Yeah,
they
like
choke.
On a golf course.
Yeah, you know, like on a golf, it's choke. It happens from time to time. No, everybody killed a black person is they choked.
Yeah, stop.
Hey, y'all, he has to go. There's no way around this here.
So please, let's send everyone to vote.org if you haven't already registered. And if you haven't registered, what are you waiting for? It only takes like 2 minutes. Go to vote.org. Please get all your early voting information so we can be ready when it's time.
So we can early mail vote. In these ballots. Yeah. Take your ballot to the post office. Don't even play with these people.
And take a picture of it with your camera phone so you'll have proof. Yeah, make sure you sign it. All of that. Yeah.
Man, don't miss nothing. Double check, triple check.
This is important. All right, that's vote.org, okay? Coming up at 34 minutes after the hour, we're going to switch gears. Parents, what have you done to embarrass your kids? We'll ask Steve Harvey right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Hey, Steve, you know, Jaime Foxx is returning to TV, okay? He got a deal with Netflix. It's a comedy inspired by his daughter, Corinne Foxx. It's called Dad, Stop Embarrassing Me. It explores their relationship. It will also star David Alan Grier. And it looks like, you know, it sounds like it's going to be really fun because we as Cute. Parents, I mean, yeah, we live to embarrass our kids and they hate it. I wake up to embarrass my kid just for fun.
My mama do too.
Yeah, just for fun. But so, Steve, I got to ask you, what have you I know you've done things to embarrass your kids. What have you done to embarrass your daughters or your sons? It doesn't matter.
They hate it when I put them into jokes.
Oh, really?
Dad, we want you to stop putting us in your jokes.
Oh, I said, you do all of them? You don't miss not
every
one?
Every last one, I don't give a damn. No. I said, y'all see this house? Uh-huh. You said swimming pool out there? You see the cars y'all drive? You see the college education y'all got? Mm-hmm. Jokes. Jokes paid for all this. Now, seeing as how y'all don't write no damn jokes, mm-hmm. your ass is going to have to be the damn joke.
Not the go-to joke, though.
Yeah. You got to make a contribution to have this here life.
So their friends hear it and they get teased, yeah.
Oh, man, your father said this about you on the radio. Dad, could you stop mentioning me on your radio show?
Yeah. Oh, really?
Uh-uh. Yeah. Oh, look at all that.
Sorry, Brady.
They
want to
drive
Charlie.
Your car and have a private life, huh?
Dad, what was you on your? What did you say on your show? All my friends was texting me. I don't know what I say. Something about I'm stupid. Oh, okay. Your daddy just be calling y'all stupid on the show. I heard your father say on Family Feud, he got 7 of them, and on each given day is 4 of y'all he don't even want.
Stop saying that, Steve.
Oh, that's true. What's funny? It's true.
So it looks like it's going to be a fun show. Dad, stop embarrassing me. Jaime Foxx and his daughter, Corinne Foxx. That looks like fun. And David Alan Grier.
Yes. That's so hilarious.
You could be on there too, Steve, with your stories.
I mean, recently, what have you done, Steve? Look at his lips. He's like, what happened?
I know.
What have you done recently to embarrass one of your kids?
Some everything, huh?
Mm-hmm. Who do you embarrass the most?
Let me see.
Winston?
No, the daughters, they really.
Oh, okay. All the daughters, huh?
I wear stuff they don't like, you know, stuff like that. You know, I'm an old school player. I ain't finna dress like you.
So then what do they say when you have on something?
Like, I'll talk about something they got on. Dad, this the latest. Well, that's because it's the latest. I ain't got to like it now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
How tight is your damn jeans, boy? Yeah. Dad, these are skinny jeans. But you got to wear them, though? Dad, everybody wearing them. I ain't got none.
Right then, I ain't got none. Yeah.
What about you, Junior?
Yeah.
Talk.
What's your mom do? I know. I love your family.
My mom was just pulling up at the comedy show. At the ticket window, just loud. My son is the headline. What the hell you mean ain't no more tickets? She don't know I told her I got her ticket. She arguing with the lady. I'll tell you right now. Holding the whole lineup, Carla. Calling everybody. Is he back there? Is he back there? Hold on. Lady, don't touch me. Now she about
not
to
don't touch me.
Yeah.
Not security.
Get her hands off me. She up there just causing a fuss at the front of the line. Man,
you're
the craziest
family.
Mama, why don't you do like I told you? I said just call me. I got your tickets.
Uh-huh. They're not
quit going up there. People don't want to talk to you.
We'll call.
Yeah, we'll call later.
That's funny.
Yeah.
I love it. Cute.
All right, guys. Go to Steve Harvey FM on Instagram or Facebook and tell us what you've done to embarrass your kids. All right. And coming up next, nephew's out. Junior's here, though, for today's prank phone call right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Coming up at the top of the hour, right about 4 minutes after, it's my strawberry letter for today. The subject, he's louder than I am. but right now, Junior is in for the nephew with today's prank phone call. What you got for us today, Junior?
You know, Shirley, right now, we just doing name pranks today. we have Scarface. That's it. Just the rapper out of Houston, okay. Scarface. Yeah. So this prank today is called Scarface. Run it, Cat.
Hey.
I'm trying to reach a Brad Jordan, a.k.a. Scarface.
You might have the wrong number.
Who is this here?
Who is this here?
My name is Craig. I'm with NCRA. That's No Cussing Rappers Association. May I speak to a Brad Jordan?
Wait. Yeah, you got the right number.
Okay, is this Scarface? Or should I say Mr. Brad Jordan?
Is this the No Cussing Association?
I said NCRA, No Cussing Rappers Association. And what we doing is we shutting down rappers that do all this cussing and this profanity on their CDs.
Well, you're a bad You shut me down. Okay. I want to see that happen.
Okay, hold up, sir. First of all, I'm going to tell you this. I just want to sit down and have a meeting with you and listen to your CD and make sure it's no crazy lyrics in it, because I am with the No Cussing Rapping Association.
Yeah. Who put you on that?
What you mean, who put me on this, sir?
Yeah, okay. So yeah, we can set up an interview. Meet where you at?
I'll tell you what, this is what I'm gonna do, sir. I don't wanna really I'm self-appointed, okay? So what I don't wanna do is I don't wanna call Jay-Z or Jermaine Dupri and get them all in this. All I want is to hear your CD before it's dropped, because what I'm not gonna do, I'm not gonna let it get released if it is not what I want on a CD from now on. NCRA, No Cussing Rappers Association, we are here to stop all cussing on these CDs.
Okay. All right, well, you got a big mountain to climb. I want to see you do that. You and what army going to do this?
I have quite a few people that are following me with the NCRA. There's quite a few. Okay. Matter of fact, there's 250 strong at this point of the No Cussing Rappers Association, sir.
You said 250 strong?
Give or take a few.
All right, well, bring them with you. You're going to need them.
Sir, listen. I'm going to say this to you one time. How can I get your CD in my hand so I can listen to it, verify that it's good to go to the shelf or not go to the shelf? Now, one thing I want to tell you is this here. We don't have a fear of any of you rappers. Let's get that out there now. Now, I know your name is Mr. Scarface, but I will put a scar on your face.
Hold on. Let me make it real clear to you, man. Let me put something on your mind so you can feel, you know, a little bit better about yourself. Get you some business, here. Yeah? Hey, you barking up the wrong tree, homeboy. Sir, now, I'm not going to play no games with you, but you stay out of my business.
Sir, all I'm saying is I want to hear.
And you and your 250. You, man, buy the you want to hear. That's what you do. Download it.
I'm not going to.
You ain't got to do a but make it like smart.
I'm definitely.
That way, me and you can definitely have a problem.
Sir, I'm trying not to have a problem with you.
With me, you're going to have a problem, and I'm going to leave it like that, man. You can take it how you want to take it. Print that.
I'm not leaving it. You act like I'm scared of you. I'm not afraid of you. I am with skin.
Man, I don't give a f- who you with, man. You can be with whoever the f- you want to be with. You look here, man.
I'm with NCRA, No Cussing Rappers Association.
I'm with these.
You know what? Your mind is playing tricks on you.
Your mind playing tricks on you. Watch your Come on, homeboy.
Sir, I'm going to say this one time to you, and I'm trying to really keep it formal. Mr. Scarface, hello? Did he hang up? Call him back.
Mr. Scarface, I'm calling back again. Gonna prank your heart, and Tommy's gonna win.
Hey.
Why the hell are you hanging up on me?
Hey, man, look here, man. No, you with me, man. Let me tell you something, man. I ain't no fucking armist, you know? Fire me. Get me fired.
I'm not. You're
not. No, man. I don't want to hear that, man.
Ain't you self-employed?
I employ my self. You sure right.
All right, then. I'm
you
with
work
no.
For whoever that is you work for, man, but you stay out my business, man.
I'm with No Cussing Rappers Association, and I need
you. Hey, man, I don't give a damn who you with, homeboy. Look here, man. You burning up my business. It's too early for this, homeboy. Do you
want to meet me to square this away? Because I don't have a problem with that. But you're not going to be cussing on these albums. I mean that.
Where you want to meet at, homeboy? So we can get this Wait, how you want to do it?
It don't make me know. I told you I got 250 followers. Give or take a few.
I don't give a damn how many people you had, man.
I don't.
You can't even begin to imagine what's going to go down if you play these games with me, man.
I will have people picking it.
Look here, man. I'm going to put the brakes on this right now, man, because you piss me off. You can call me with this like you like, man, like you showing up and pull some strings to stop my man. Look here, man. Instead of being concerned about what the I'm saying and what I'm doing, man, you might need to step back and take a look at the condition of these in the first place and why they in that position, homeboy. And what I said ain't got to do with it, all right? That's that Willie Lynch, man. Y'all put that on me like it's my fault. I know what I'm talking about, and you don't. It's on that, huh?
What is you talking about, Willie Lynch? What is you talking about?
That's all right. Read about it. You
trying to act like you got more knowledge than me now.
I'm not trying to act like a thing. I tell you what, though. And I'm going to say what I want. And just say that MRC, who the hell you with?
No,
put that on there, too.
No rapping, cussing, or so. No cuss. You know who I'm with.
Yeah, I know who you're going to be with. You keep with me.
Who?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, can I say something else to you?
You can't say a thing to me. I'm through with you.
This is Nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show. You just got prank scar face.
Man, y'all wrong.
Face, where you at, baby?
I'm trying to figure out who I'm going to sit up there. I'm trying to hook up with you real quick. I'm 250 people. Man, Lord have mercy. All right, man. Y'all got me. You got me.
I got you, Face. I'm from the crib. Yeah, you my homeboy. I had to go get you, man.
Come on, now, man. You do me like that, man. Now, you know, I don't say no bad words like that, man. Y'all told me like I was. But that was a good one, dog.
All right, brother.
That right there was a good one, man. And no matter how the No Rappers Cussing Association try to point that blame at what these rappers is doing, man, that's a lot that happened way before the rappers did it.
Yeah, you right about that, now.
You know what I mean?
That's real talk. That's real talk. All right, let me ask you one more thing, baby. What is the baddest radio show in the land?
Yeah, the Steve Harvey Morning Show, man. You already know, and you got me on it, too. Tell Steve I say what's handling, man.
There it is, Scarface. He's from the No Cussing Rappers Association. Uh-huh. He don't want him cussing too much on his album. That's pretty much that prank. Scarface.
You prank somebody from Fifth Ward, Texas.
Yeah,
huh?
Yeah, that's really a good way to get whooped.
Yeah. You know, man.
You know what, y'all? Tommy's not here. I want to say this.
I'll
protect him, you know, because we family and everything. And I go down with him. I'll fight with him. But
of course.
I am really looking forward to the day when he get jumped on.
No, don't say that, Steve. You
can't
believe
that. No, really, I am.
I can't believe you said that.
And when it happened, I'm going to let a couple blows get in before I jump in.
Uh-uh.
But I'm going to make sure they touch his ass real good, though. But I'm so looking forward to that. It's just going to be.
Said
that, man. Oh, no, I want it. It's all that's good. But just, he going to get jumped on.
I can't believe you said that, man.
I'm going to do about 10 seconds. I ain't going to do nothing. I'm going to act like I'm getting up to come over there.
Yeah,
but you know the thing about Tommy is, and I hate to say this kind of, but not really.
Oh yeah, here we go. What, Steve?
You know, all of this, it has to happen because he's just stupid.
All right, thank you, Junior, in for the nephew. Up next, it's the Strawberry Letter. Subject, he's louder than I am. We'll get into it right after this.
You, Tommy.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Well, only 60 days left until November 3rd. Go to vote.org and get registered. You can do it right now. It only takes a couple of minutes. Plus, you can get all of your early voting information for your state. That is vote.org. We are serious. We are not playing. This is not a game. Okay? Vote.org. And it's time now, as we switch gears, for today's Strawberry Letter. If you need advice on relationships, dating, work, sex, parenting, and more, please submit your Strawberry Letter to steveharveyfm.com and click Submit Strawberry Letter. We could be reading your letter live on the air, just like we're going to read this one right here, right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is that time. It's time for today's Strawberry Letter with my good friend, Shirley Strawberry.
Thank you, Junior. Subject, he's louder than I am. Dear Stephen Shirley, I am a 33-year-old woman, and I recently started dating a 25-year-old man. The age difference really didn't bother me at first, but I am starting to notice that he seems to be a little bit inexperienced when it comes to sex. The first time we got together, there was a lot of kissing involved, so I didn't quite notice how much noise he makes in bed. I did notice that he was talking really dirty, and maybe he thinks that all women are into that, or he hasn't been with that many women. Now that we've done it a few times, it's starting to get a little awkward and embarrassing. The other night, we tried doing it in a few different positions, and he got louder each time. He was moaning and cursing. Then he started to scream my name, and I thought the neighbors were going to think something was wrong. I should probably take it as a compliment, but this is too over the top to me, and I think he might be faking or exaggerating because he thinks that's what he's supposed to do. He got very embarrassed when I called him out on it and said it's completely natural. I told him I don't like to be rude or obnoxious to my neighbors, so he needs to work on being less noisy. I know this is a strange request because usually it's the women that are the most vocal during intimacy, but this guy cannot keep it down. I have tried to play music or I'll leave the TV on to drown out all of his screams and curse words, but nothing works. He's a great guy, and this is something we can work on. I need some advice. Wow, you just got to say something. I mean, you got to let him know how you feel. You said you've talked to him before, and he said it was natural. But I think it's a little more serious than maybe, you guys think it is, or especially him. You want the sex to be good, but you don't want it to be annoying and embarrassing, like you said, and awkward. You don't want it to be too loud, I guess, because of your neighbors. And he's just in there just cussing and just hollering, huh? Anyway, your neighbors don't need to know all your business. They don't need to know what you're doing. They don't need to hear all of that all the time. I think the problem with letting him know, what you want is that, you got to be careful. You can do it, but just don't crush the man. Don't crush him. Just, say you're telling him again because, you really want it to work out. Like you say, this is something you guys can work on, but just be mindful of his very fragile ego. You know, men have fragile egos. He's only 25. You have 8 years on him. So let him know how you feel nicely. Hopefully he'll get the message and shut up with all that hollering. Steve?
Nah, Shirley, that ain't it. Nice try to give a nice answer. Wholesome family entertainment. Yeah, I got it for you, though.
Uh-oh. Let's hear
33-year-old woman just started dating a 25-year-old man. 8 years.
Yeah.
Now, already, a man is not fully matured at 25.
Mm-hmm.
A woman is around 33. Mm-hmm. Women mature faster than men. So your 8 years difference in dog years is about 20 years.
Dog years? These are humans.
You way past this boy right here. You 33, he 25. You putting something on him. Mm-hmm. He ain't air had. And it is starting to show.
Yeah.
And he can't help it. You say the age didn't bother you. But now you didn't notice his, be a little bit experienced when it comes to sex. Man, he just don't know what you know. Oh. Now, is he inexperienced or you something else? Question again.
That's the question.
Is he inexperienced
or
are you something else? Are you lo and behold, all hell no? She don't sound reserved to me because first got together with a lot of kissing, so I ain't quite noticed how much noise he was making in bed. I did notice that he was talking really dirty. Maybe he think that's what all women into, that he ain't been with that many women. Now, I don't know what he was saying. We'll get to that in a minute.
Oh, Lord.
But now that we done it a few times, it just started to get a little awkward and embarrassing. The other night, we tried doing it in a few positions, and he got louder each time he was moaning. Oh!
Here we go.
Oh, we switching positions.
Oh! Fails.
Oh, this finna be another trick. Oh, tricking me again. Oh, now you want to put your knee on the nightstand while I got my leg on the heater. Oh, hell.
On the heater.
Nah.
Crazy, man.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to do it now. He was moaning and cussing. Then he started to screaming my name. Oh!
Michelle Darlene Hawkins, you better not be up in here doing all this to me.
Michelle
Darlene Hawkins. Wow, my name Gertrude.
Hold on. Yeah. All right, look, we'll have part two of Steve's response coming up at 23 minutes after the hour. Today's subject, he's louder than I am. We'll get back into it right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Come on, Steve. Let's recap today's strawberry letter. The subject, he's louder than I am.
Yeah.
Wow.
33-year-old grown thing. This grown woman right here met the little boy. Well, he a grown man, but he 25. She ain't there putting something on him he ain't never had before. She ain't noticed how much noise he making being. He talking real dirty to her, too.
I think he was cussing, though.
Me, too.
Yeah, but I don't want to do that because
y'all
going to keep
it. You can't do it on the air, no.
But then he started to scream in my name. I'm going to repeat her name for you just the way he said it. Ah, Michelle Darlene Hawkins. He just hollered. You thought the neighbors was going to think something was wrong.
Yes.
I should probably take it as a compliment, but this is too over the top for me, and I think we might be faking it. Faking it? How you faking hollering? He hollering and cussing. I think he's exaggerating because he thinks that's what he's supposed to do. He got very embarrassed when I called him out on it and said it's completely natural. I told him I don't like to be rude or obnoxious to my neighbors, so he need to work on being less noisy. I know this is a strange request because usually it's the woman that's the most vocal during intimacy. But this guy can't keep it down. I've tried to play music. I leave the TV on to drown out all the screams and cuss words, but ain't nothing work. He's a great guy, and this is something we can work on. I need some advice. Well, me and Shirley going to reenact something not on radio. You know, it's going to be red radio version of it.
Okay.
So, Shirley, what I want you to do is just, this is what we do. This is actually happening in real time. They're in bed, and all she's trying to do is have a normal conversation with him.
Okay.
But he ain't trying to have it.
And a normal conversation? Getting.
Just a normal conversation.
Okay. Like, how was your day? Like that.
Just regular conversation about how the day went or anything like that. He turning it all around.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hi, honey.
Oh, hi, hell.
Woo!
Girl, high way better than low. Come on over here.
You look very handsome today.
I got something high for you. I know good and hell well I'm handsome. We both handsome. Everything I got handsome. Woo! I got a hand and some for you. Come on over here. Got about to get nasty.
Well, honey, how was your day? Did you have a good day?
How the hell you think my day was? I was thinking about tonight the whole damn day. Grabbing and touching and snatching and biting and chewing, wrestling and gripping and slipping and sliding, baby oil, Lysol, Lysol, everything. I got everything over here.
Well, you're hungry, honey? I was going to
hell yeah. Like a snack. You finna get like a pepperoni pizza with extra meat on it, girl.
Well, I was going to just make
you up. Huh?
Some steak and potatoes and a veggie. That's
you are. You look like a steak and a potato. Yeah, you look like a hungry man TV dinner. Come on over here, cut that TV off. So, matter of fact, cut that TV up so the neighbor can't hear me eat this hungry man dinner.
But I didn't know what you wanted I was struggling with dessert.
Did you just say butt? That's exactly what I'm looking for. Some more butt.
What did you want for dessert, honey? With this?
I got all the dessert I need. I want some pudding pie. I want some pudding pie. That's what I want.
Did you want drinks first, or did you
I'm thirsty.
Want some wine with the meal, some red wine?
Nobody want nothing to drink. Girl, I'm finna drink your bath water. What I'm finna drink.
Well, I am kind of tired. I did need like a foot rub or something.
Nobody got time to rub your foot.
Yeah, that's what
Put your foot in my mouth. That's what I want to do, girl. Put your whole foot down in my nasty mouth while I'm cussing. I want your foot in my mouth while I'm cussing on it.
cussing on your toes.
Well, honey, after dinner, did you want to watch a movie or something?
I want to watch a movie. Porno. Matter of fact, let's make it our damn self. Nasty movie. We're going to call it Two Nasty People Making a Movie After Dinner.
That's a long title.
That's a long title, yeah.
Everybody going to want it. I got a whole scene. We're going to reenact the Mimi scene on the shower curtain.
Well, you know, this weekend is Labor Day, so.
Labor? You trying to have a baby? Oh, we going to be doing it that hard? We're going to have a baby by Friday? Girl, you going to try to get some of this here?
I wanted to know if you wanted to have people over or did you want to go to
people,
a cookout?
Orgy. Hell yeah. Yeah. Everybody can come over. Your sister, Nate Nim, Geraldine Nim. Everybody.
Yeah, we could, you know, like put some barbecue on the grill or something, put some meat on the grill.
Grill.
Some hot dogs.
Grill your ass. That's what I've been trying to do right here, put a grill mark on it right there. Look like a spatula when you cross it. Spack, spack.
That's the problem she's having.
Ooh, you got out of character.
25-year-old boy.
Oh, man.
Everything you say to a 25, his hormones is raging. An all-time high. And there's nothing you could do about it. I want to applaud myself for giving an edited, nasty version with no cussing and very radio playable. They'll be running that back playable. All across the country. Thank you so much.
Post your comments. Thank you, Steve. On today's Strawberry Letter at Steve Harvey FM.
I got to go
FM.
Tape Family Feud now.
On Instagram and Facebook and check out the Strawberry Letter podcast on demand. Now, coming up at 46 minutes after, you know what time it is. Our girl from the talk, Sheryl Underwood, would be here.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Coming up at the top of the hour, Carla's reality update. But right now, Steve, please introduce our girl from the top.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Give it all up that you got for Sheryl Underwood.
Thank you, Steve Harvey. Matter of fact, I'm so happy. I feel like singing. Love is in the air every time I look around. That's right, Junior. Today is your lucky day.
What?
You know why?
Me.
Niece and Nance got married. Yes. Okay, now check it out now. Wait a minute. See, I got my girls right here. I got Carla, got Shirley. Yes. All right, Steve, get ready to bring out a Bible and cater everything. Because me and Junior got to get married. If Nisa Nash can get married. Look at here. Look at here, boy. Look at here. Junior, what will my last name be? Because I got to hurry and change my last name so I can register to vote. Because we need to vote Trump ass out of office. All right, let's go, Junior. Okay, now how many of your kin peoples need to come to the wedding? What's happening? Steve, how big is your backyard? What? That's the wedding. Okay,
it's
so how many Popeye chicken sandwiches? Okay, how many Popeye chicken sandwiches we need for the reception? Because we can cut them in half. All right, now
three.
We need a band. No, okay, that's good. Three sandwiches, that's for six people. Now we need Jan Brown. He need to be an usher, a DJ, and security at the same
Cheryl,
time.
Cheryl, who is you voting for? Stop all this ordering sandwiches for the wedding that ain't happening. Who you voting for?
I'm riding with Biden, man.
We got things to do then. Why?
Because Junior told me if you don't, we ain't never gonna be together. I was like, all right, I was already voting for him, but that sealed the deal for me. Let's go, boy. We about to be together. Look here, if Niece and Nath can find somebody that she loves and walk down the aisle in a white dress, happily in the after, then so can I. I will be wearing white. Everybody that I ever slept with, don't call in and start talking about what we used to do. My life is different now. I can wear white, damn it. Don't you say nothing. I can wear white. So, Junior, okay. What is your favorite cake? What you want? German chocolate cake from scratch? Because we got to have a wedding cake. We need a band. Can we get, you know what? Roger Troutman, Zap is still a good band.
They got a cold show.
I love it.
Oh, them boys is cold. Let me tell you something. Them boys get on the bus. This is going to be the best wedding we ever had. Now, look, I was thinking Confunction because I need to hear Straight from the Heart walk down the aisle. But maybe the OJs, if I can get Stairway to Heaven and the OJ, we cry together. Maybe I can get that. It'll be just like the hoodies, but it'll be our wedding. Stop playing, Junior. Now, you can eat pork, can't you? Because we don't have swine because I'm Arkansas. Got to have some pig. Everybody call it right now. If you believe that me and Junior, if Niecy Nas can get married, me and Junior go get married. What, Steve Harvey? What? What?
Congratulations. What can we say?
Thank you.
Congratulations. Yeah. Thank you,
Sheryl.
I accept.
Did he ask?
We got to go right now, though. Coming up at the top of the hour.
Y'all are maids of honor. Y'all maids of honor and y'all security. Don't let no bitch walk up on my maid at my wedding.
Carla's reality update coming up right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, Junior, come on. Introducer, let's go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is that time. It's time for our reality update with my girl, Carla Pharrell.
All right, thank you, Junior. Nephew.
Ooh, this is my segment. Come on. I'm ready.
This is your segment. And you know what? Next week, Steve, I want you to give us an update on 90 Day Fiancé. People have been asking for you. You got fans out there.
Yeah, you don't even understand.
So we'll take care of them. So let's go. Real Housewives of Potomac. All right. So Ashley was getting ready to go to Monique's house. Monique invited the ladies. You know how it goes, Steve, to the lake house. But it was to the lake house. Mm-hmm. And her husband, Ashley's husband, Michael, was like, you taking the baby, right? Because Ashley just gave birth to their son and they have a little bitty baby. And Ashley was like, yeah, I'm going to take the baby. But he was like, babies at his age, they need their mom. So you're taking your baby, taking our baby. So I didn't like the way he said it, though.
I didn't
either. He got on my nerves with that. Mm-hmm. So anyway.
Yeah. Because so he ain't had no problem with they making baby.
Right.
Boom. There you go. So the ladies, they start arriving to the lake house and getting settled in. And Monique, okay, so she's an animal lover. So she has this pet bird. Oh, my goodness. And she calls the bird T'Challa. Yes, just like the character from Black Panther. Yes, yes. That's the name of the bird. Yes, Junior. Anyway, the ladies don't understand what's up with Monique and taking this bird everywhere. The bird is getting on their nerves. So they're at the lake house. They're getting settled in. There's a new housewife. Her name is Wendy. And so Wendy arrives. She's upset that Ashley brought her baby on the girls' trip to the lake house because Wendy just had a baby girl, too. Mm-hmm. So she was going in on that. Well, why'd you bring your baby? I could have brought my baby. It was all of this. And the ladies on the show was like, look, Wendy, this is your third child. This is her first child. She's a new mom. Let her have that. Let her have that moment. Anyway, she was going in. Wendy was saying she wants to get to know the ladies on a deeper level. And when she said deeper level, this bird took off and attacked her. I don't know if it was the word. Don't start that out here at this party.
Oh, no, you not, Heifer.
Okay. This bird went
flew into her ass.
I'm talking about attacked her. It was hilarious. Uh-huh. It was when she said the word, I want to get to know y'all on a deeper level. The bird said, chew, went right at her. Yes. So it was really, really hilarious.
Come up in my master's house, start no mess, Heifer.
Exactly. So we will see what happens on the trip. They had a dinner, you know. It was drama, so I will keep you posted and let you know what will happen next week with the Lake House. The reality competition show Dancing with the Stars is set. New host, new EP, executive producer, Tyra Banks. Yes, so shout out to the sister Tyra Banks doing it.
Okay.
Yeah, and the celebrities for Dancing with the Stars Junior Season 29 are Nelly.
Yep.
Carol Baskin.
Yup.
From Tiger King. Yup.
Oh, good in hell. Well, her ass can't dance. Lion Heifer. Got this Lion Heifer on the show.
We want to know where your husband can't dance. If I'm her partner, I'm not being her.
I ain't got no money on Nelly. Hell, my boy DL was on there. I know how to be shamed.
Yep, so Nelly's on there. The catfish host. You know the guy that hosts catfish's name. Yep, Nev Schulman, he's on the show. Your boy Steve, NBA star Charles Oakley is on Dancing with
Oak
the
from
Stars.
Cleveland. It ain't gonna be good. Oak's nickname is Big Country. We grew up together in Cleveland. This ain't who you want. He gonna knock your ass out.
Oh, well, no audience on Dancing with the Stars, so we'll see it with Tyra Banks. Hit me up at Lips by Carla. We'll talk more about reality update on the gram, on Twitter. What you got, Shirley girl?
All right, coming up, more of the Steve Harvey Morning Show and some trending stories 20 minutes Ooh. After. We'll be back right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
What's going on in COVID-19 trending medical news? Well, Dr. Fauci said, be a part of the solution and not the problem this Labor Day weekend. This would set the tone for the outbreak for the fall. Don't forget, the fall is coming. It also appears that new cases and positivity rates are now surging in the Midwest, like Iowa. Also, the CDC is telling states to prepare for coronavirus vaccine distribution as soon as late October or early November. I even heard on Election Day. They want it out, okay?
He thinking of everything, ain't he?
Yeah, everything.
He giving you everything to do but vote. You know Trump thought this up.
Mm-hmm.
The CDC, it seems like they are being pushed to change things, their recommendations, move up deadlines. I don't know. It seems a little political.
I think he's hired that guy.
Yeah.
That CDC. Naval guy.
Uh-huh.
That he handpicked to put in charge of the CDC.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I think, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. Even the coronavirus task force, I mean, you don't hear hardly anything from them anymore. They used to update us every single day, you know, but now you hardly hear anything. And it seems like there's a problem with Dr. Fauci, you know.
But 185,000 people have died dead from this disease. Yeah. How do you feel like you shouldn't be updating?
Right, and over 6 million people have it. All right, we'll have more of the Steve Harvey Morning Show and more trending stories at 33 minutes after the hour, right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Time now for Ask the CLO. All you have to do is go to Steve Harvey FM to submit your questions for the Chief Love Officer. Are you ready, sir?
Bone ready.
All right, Calvin in Seattle says, I'm a 47-year-old married man and I have a blended family with my wife. She's Caucasian and I'm African American. My children are both in college, but her two teenagers live with us. We've never had the same parenting style, so I just bite my tongue and overlook a lot because
Did he
I
say
know
both her children live with them?
My children are both in college, but her two teenagers live with them.
Okay.
We've never had the same parenting style, so I just bite my tongue and overlook a lot because I know the children will be out of the house soon. But over the past 3 weeks, her 16-year-old daughter's boyfriend has been spending the night at our house. If they fall asleep watching the movies, they sleep together on our sofa. I don't like it one bit, but my wife says it's innocent and she did it when she was a teenager. Should I let it go or put my foot down?
No, walk in there and wake his ass up and say, hey, little man, time for you to move on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't care what the wife say. It might be innocent. Get your innocent ass up and go home.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you said they have two different parenting styles.
Yeah, this ain't about parenting. This boy ain't changed your child.
Mm-hmm.
Wake up, my man. Wake up. You got to go home. Mm-hmm. Sorry about that. You can't spend the night in my house. You're not married. I don't care about this. Bye. Where your parents at?
Yeah.
I'm not sleeping with this boy in my house. I don't know him.
Okay. All right, so the dad, the man of the house, should go wake him up.
I don't care who. You're not falling asleep over here, partner. Mm-hmm. Let's go. Let's move on.
Because it's okay with the mom, so the mom and the
I was in college and used to fall asleep over my girlfriend's house.
Mm-hmm.
Dog, I had to go home. I had to go home.
Yeah.
And we was dating heavy in college, but we was both in Cleveland. Mm-hmm. I couldn't spend the night at her house. You got to go, my man.
Okay.
Whatever y'all doing in college, that's on y'all. But when you come here, you got to respect my house.
Under my roof.
Go to sleep.
Yeah.
That's all.
All right. Moving on, CLO. Sue in Columbus, Georgia says, I've been married for almost 40 years, and I think my husband is cheating. We're both retired, but he's been helping out his friend that owns a hardware store. Since then, I've noticed a big change in him. He is very conscious about what he wears out of the house now, and he douses his clothes in this new cologne he got. I usually give him cologne for Christmas, and he's been wearing the same one for years. He told me his buddy at the job gave it to him. I didn't press the issue, but I am worried that there's another woman in the picture. Do you think he's cheating?
Well, first of all, let's start with this cologne you get him Merry Christmas. He don't want it no more. You want to try somebody. Yeah, y'all been married 40 years. People get sick of Brute.
Coming up, it's our last break of the day.
It's the last break of the day.
And coming up at 49 minutes after, some closing remarks from the one and only Steve Harvey right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, 2 months exactly, 60 days left until November 3rd. Go to vote.org to get registered. Takes about 2 minutes or so. Plus, you can get your information on early voting in your state, just what you need to do, what you need to bring, all of that. If anything, just be prepared. We want you to be prepared so you can vote and vote early. All right? That is vote.org. Vote.org. That's where you need to go. That's what you need to know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Vote.
Yeah. I'm getting excited about voting, too. Oh. You know, let's go ahead and do it and let the chips fall where they may.
Well, I think we should all be excited about voting. Mm-hmm. I think this is the election where we can really, really prove a point.
Mm-hmm.
This is the election where we can make ourselves known as a powerhouse voting bloc. This is the election where we can take credit for its direction. Let me give you an example. Joe Biden was not doing well in the primaries until Congressman or Senator Claiborne.
Jim Clyburn. Mm-hmm.
Until he got in there and got everybody out to the polls in South Carolina, it resurrected Joe Biden's campaign. And it's been that way ever since. Everybody is trying to win the black vote. Look at Donald Trump's Republican National Convention that was televised. Have you ever seen that many black people around Donald Trump anywhere?
No.
Ever. The five people that they sworn in as United States citizens.
Oh,
he don't even like Africa or Haiti, swearing them in, welcoming them to the country. He done already said how he felt about them two countries, man. This dude was so obviously trying to attract the black vote. We have got to understand that our vote is attractive to everybody. So we should start wielding that vote like it is the power block that it is. We can control what happens in November. If we show up at the polls, we get to say what we won't tolerate anymore. If you don't like the divisiveness in this country, you can vote to do something about it. If you are sick of our president not ever mentioning Black Lives Matter, only Blue Lives Matter, that's a sad statement to make, man. Because, you know, listen, I'm okay with there being a lot of great policemen and women out there. I get it, and it is. But it's a lot of bad ones. It's not a few. It's a lot of bad ones. It's not only the ones that pull the triggers or choke the people out or sit on their necks. It's the ones that's right there with them and let it go down and then collaborate when it's time to fill out the police report to come up with some other type of incriminating evidence to make it sound like this person's redone. Do you know that they have Jacob Blake, who is paralyzed from these 7 shots in the back? Do you know that they have him handcuffed to a bed? Because it is to insinuate that he has broken a law and he is a criminal. So as they put their story together in Kenosha, Wisconsin, that's why he's handcuffed to the bed. That don't make no sense, man. That's inhumane treatment. The man is paralyzed by no action of his own. And we got a president that won't admit to that. That we have a president that condoned this 17-year-old boy taking a rifle and killing two people because he said, you know, it's being said he could have feared for his life. There's a lot to be learned there. No, man, he took a rifle and he killed two people. There's nothing else to learn. Do you know the attorney general in the state of Kentucky who will not prosecute or bring charges against the police officers that killed Breonna Taylor? Do you know that he spoke at the Republican National Convention? Do you know that he's a 33-year-old black dude? And he keeps saying everything he can to talk about we're still under investigation. What? You went into a woman's house with a no-knock warrant looking for a person who was already incarcerated. You opened fire and you killed this girl. All you have to do is take all the firearms from all the police officers that checked their guns out that night, shoot their guns into a barrel, take all of the shells in the walls and in the body, all of the bullets, and comparing to the score marks that's on the barrel at all the guns, and you'll know exactly who shot the woman, and you know exactly who shot into the wall. That's basic math. But this black dude who was sitting up there praising Trump won't do it. And he's black. And he's 33. He is just as much a part of systemic racism in this country than former slave owners. I'm sorry, man. We got a lot at stake this election right here. We got a lot of reasons to vote. I'm going to keep trying to find new ways to employ and empower everybody to vote. But we got to vote. I'm calling my sisters, man. I'm going to make sure that my two sisters and brothers got their, because they old. And I'm going to make sure they got their ballots in and they get their vote in. Make sure that the people in your family is voting. Y'all got good sense, man. Don't let this go down. It's easy. Go to vote.org. Vote.org. And you can get everybody registered in a couple of minutes, man. You can get your ballot sent to your house. You can mail your vote in. You can go down and early vote to beat the crowds. But if you end up waiting until November 4th, we're going to them damn polls anyway. Cannot let this man have four more years of destroying this country that we built. And we're going to make this Constitution be ours if it's the last thing we do, like it or not.
For all Steve Harvey contests, no purchase necessary, void where prohibited. Participants must be legal U.S. residents at least 18 years old unless otherwise stated. For complete contest rules, visit SteveHarveyFM.com.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.